Hi everybody, it's Martin from the Washboard Resonators. On this week's video, it's just filth, flan, filth. We're going to look at the worst, rudest, old-fashioned blues and jazz songs. Of course, it's impossible to do the top 10 rude blues songs. There are so many. What I'm hoping is that this is a good starting off point.
I got nipples on my titties, big as the end of my thumb. I got something between my legs, I'll make a dead man come.
So at number one, I've picked what is probably the most obscene, which is Shave 'em Dry by Lucille Bogan. This song has an interesting history. So there was two versions by Lucille Bogan. There was one that was released in 1935. The second version was done as a kind of, I believe it was like a kind of a studio joke, and just produced as an example record. And it was given to one of the executives at the record company as a kind of joke. And somehow that version came down the line and ended up getting included on a compilation in the 80s or the 90s. That's the version now that everybody's kind of heard, with the lyrics that I'm going to flash up that I don't even want to say. That is a song which is obscene, and it was, I believe, a joke, which is why when you hear it, you'll hear her laughing. She doesn't really sing the phrasing right. She's reading off a piece of paper. They're messing about in the studio and they're just saying this filth. This was never meant to be like public.
Let me put my banana in your fruit basket, and I'll be satisfied.
So number two is Banana in Your Fruit Basket by Bo Carter. And he could have five songs in the top 10. He's got songs like Your Biscuits Are Big Enough For Me, My Pencil Won't Write No More, and Please Warm My Wiener. So his song Banana in Your Fruit Basket was released in 1931. Check him out if you like our band, the Washboard Resonators. Hey, he's playing a lovely, brand new national style N on this recording.
There's one pet I like to pet, and every evening we get set. I stroke it every chance I get, it's my girl's pussy.
So next up is a British song, and this is a great one. This is Harry Roy and his orchestra, My Girl's Pussy. This is another song released in 1931, actually the year this was made. And you know, the song starts out with cats meowing, and then he talks about stroking his cat, his pussy, and making it happy. It's particularly funny because of his ridiculous British accent.
I want my honey every morning, late at night, but don't get my honey, don't leave him, treat it just right, sweet honey ho, sweet honey ho.
At number four, one of my favourite performers, Blind Boy Fuller and his disgraceful song, Sweet Honey Hole. This was a song released in 1937. I don't even know what the lyrics mean in this. I wish I did. But I get the idea that it's absolutely disgusting and nobody in their right mind should go and listen to it. Also, he's another resonator player. Hey, and you know, you listen to his music, there's some serious songs, there's some spiritual songs, there's some blues songs, there's some rude hokum songs. He plays a resonator. He also plays often with a washboard player. I wonder who would, you know, which other bands might do that. There's nothing new.
If you see my gal, tell her to hurry home. I ain't had no bread, since she's been gone. You know it's tight like that. Beat it up, on boy, tight like that. Beat it up, on do you hear me talking? I made it tight like that.
So what's at number five? Someone might be asking. It's Tampa Red and Georgia Tom with It's Tight Like That from 1928. So Tampa Red could have a lot of songs as well, and this song really started, really was a big hit by surprise, and really started this whole genre of hokum music. Double entendre, good time, blues and jazz inspired, kind of, you know, rude kind of song making. So from this hit, it spawned so many other kinds of hits. I love Tampa Red because, you know, he's a great player and he uses a resonator again. And interestingly, Georgia Tom, you know, very successful working with Tampa Red, producing Rude Music, but he actually went on to become the biggest writer of gospel and spiritual music in the 1930s and 40s as Tom Dorsey. So at number six, it's a song called It's Tight Like That. Similar title. Well, this time it's Clara Smith in 1929. She took the Tampa Red song and she did her own version. It's similar, it's slowed down, the lyrics are changed, it's more of a jazz band backing. I like the middle verse where it's about Uncle Bill not being able to get his key in the lock. It is particularly not in terms of filth. Okay, so before we get to number seven, here's a good time just to say, if you're interested in old 1920s, 30s, 40s music, resonator guitars, blues, swing, jazz, ragtime, do subscribe. It really helps me and Jack, the Washboard Resonators. Check out our videos. Go into the description. You can like, you can subscribe, you can join the mailing list. It all helps massively. We appreciate it. Thank you.
With me little stick of flag and rock, along the promenade I stroll. It may be sticky, but I never complain. It's nice to have a nibble at it now and again.
So number seven is Little Stick of Blackpool Rock by another British guy, George Formby, who I love. A song released in 1937. Now 70% of our viewers are in the USA, so I might just explain about George Formby so he makes sense to all you guys. So George Formby was probably the biggest British entertainer of the 1930s. His thing was he did double entendre songs set to ukulele. His whole act was really influenced by that kind of hokum movement that came out of America. Now, in his song, My Little Stick of Blackpool Rock, let me try and make sense of that. In Britain, we have a place called Blackpool, which is probably the equivalent of like your Atlantic City, which was this kind of seaside fun palace where, you know, a lot of the working class British, in America you'd say blue collar people, went to holiday or vacation, as you would say. Two peoples commoned by a joined language. So over here we call them sweeties, but over there you call them candies. And the stick of rock is a stick of like sugar candy that you only sell in Britain by the seaside coast. So the entire song's talking about, he's got this stick of stuff and he's going around and it's very sticky and people can nibble on it and someone tries to take a picture and you can't see him because of how big his stick of rock is.
I need a little sugar in my bowl. I need a little hot dog on my roll. I can stand a bit of loving, oh so bad.
At number eight, it's Need Some Sugar in My Bowl by Bessie Smith, a masterclass by the Empress of the Blues, when she sings the need. In need, you know what she's meaning, and it's fantastic. So let's just do the last two songs now. At number nine, it's Keep On Churning Till the Butter Comes by Winoni Harris, a song released in 1952.
Keep on churning till the butter comes. Keep on pumping, make the butter flow. Wipe off the battle and churn some more.
This song is really good at kind of walking that line between absolute vulgar, disgusting, hit yourself with a stick, filth, and just exuberant, joyful fun. I think he walks the line perfectly in this song.
That's what I like about that fat gal of mine. And when I see my landlord, there's so much of her to hide behind. Time was spent like mine.
So lastly, at number 10, it's Fat Gal by Merle Travis from 1947. This is a great song. I've played this song to so many people over the years, and I don't think anybody had ever heard it before I played it to them. And what this does really well for me is the song is tongue-in-cheek. It's talking about his girl and when he likes to make her laugh because everything moves. And when he needs pillows, there's pillows around to sleep on. So it's kind of, but there's nothing what you might think in modern day terms as like fat shaming. It's all done with a good heart and with an obvious respect and love for the person he's singing about. It's quite an astonishing song. We actually based our song, The Cake Filled Woman Blues, kind of on this idea of the song. I don't know if we actually hit what we were trying to achieve necessarily, but that's what we were attempting, was to take a song like this, which is fun and warm, and do our own version of it. So there we go. There are 10 despicably disgraceful songs for all you wrong'uns, all you bad people, all you people that stay up past midnight, all you people with very hairy palms or whatever, dark rings around your eyes. I hope that was, you know, interesting and of entertainment to you. Which songs have I missed here? Do tell us in the comments any of your favourite songs that have this kind of content, and let's try and make it a great resource for all those kind of people I just described. We'd love to hear your suggestions, because one of the great things about this channel is we always find out new stuff from what people tell us, so we'd love to hear it from you. So do subscribe, it helps. Do like the video, you can smash the like button, and do go to the description. Do find us on the internet from all the links down below. And hey, we'll see you all again soon.